Hey guys, Gut Level here, and I really need to go grocery shopping right now. I just put out a brand new overlay pack. No, it's not an overlay pack. It's a stinger transition pack on my Gumroad page. So that's gumroad.com/Gut Level. There are six stinger transition. You don't know what a stinger transition is? It's basically when you're switching from scene to scene while you're live streaming, and then a little graphic thing pops up to kind of cover the transition, like the cut, if you will. You know what it is. You've seen big streamers do it all the time. So let me show you what they look like. I guess this is also going to be a tutorial on how to add transitions to not only Streamlabs OBS, but also OBS Studio. So stick around. Okay, once you're in the editor scene in Streamlabs OBS, on top of your scene list, okay, right there, you're gonna see something that says edit scene transitions. You just need to click on that little cogwheel. Boom. Now what you can do here is either add a new transition or just edit. That little pencil usually means edit your global transition. So this is what we're gonna do right now. I'm gonna click on edit, and right there where it says transition type or just type, you're gonna pick stinger, because those are stinger transitions. Don't ask me where the term stinger comes from. I don't know. I don't care. Under video file, you're gonna click browse, and then you're gonna go find the files that you just downloaded from gumroad.com/Gut Level. But how do I know which one to download? Well, it's simple. Here's what gumroad.com/Gut Level looks like, and this is what the pack looks like. Six stinger transitions right there. Okay, so it looks like that. Don't get it confused with my other stinger transition packs. Right there, you have one with 117 in there, and then there's this one with 25 stinger transitions. But what is the difference? Well, the main difference here is that this new one is free, completely free, zero. Technically, you can donate whatever amount it asks you. Like, you can type in the price box and put whatever you want, but the product itself is free. All you need to do is type zero in that little price box, and then you get it. All right. Now, what do you get once you download it? You'll get six transitions. The files are WebM files, so make sure that whatever weird broadcasting software that you're using accepts WebM files. Okay. But if you're using Streamlabs OBS, OBS Studio, or the thing that Stream Elements has, it should be completely fine. All right. Going back to the whole Streamlabs OBS thing, you're gonna pick this one called Be There or Be Square. Let's click open, and now it's right there. Okay. Transition duration. Every transition on this pack is about 2.2 seconds. So this is in milliseconds. It's going to be 2,200 milliseconds. You can play around with those numbers, because depending on your computer, the transitions might play a little faster or a little slower. So the transition point is going to be in the middle. It's going to be around 1,100 milliseconds. Again, you might have to play around in order to find the perfect one for your machine. And then all of that is fine. Just click done. Click done, and technically you added it as a global transition. If I switch to my Be Right Back scene, for example, ooh, look at that. Oh, now that's what I call a transition. You want to see what the other ones look like? Let's do it. Okay, cogwheel, edit, browse, second one called diagonal dialogue, done, done, switch back, the other one, cogwheel, edit, browse, F Sports. Let's go to my Be Right Back scene. Wow. This one is called Jason Christ, That's Jesus Born. You don't get that reference? I don't know what to tell you. Okay, this is a great example of where you would tweak the transition point. Clearly, the transition was a little too early. That means we're going to increase the transition point in order to make it work. But also, my computer is running both OBS Studio plus Streamlabs OBS at the same time right now, so it's not in its peak performance. Let's put this one at 1,500, for example. Okay, and then, nope, click done. Does that work? Yes, it does. See? This one is called Kaleidos. Nope. Done, done. Be right back. Oh, so pretty. And this one is called Space Toad. I like that one. Click done. Click game. Okay, that one struggled a little bit. It played it really slow. Okay, now how do you do it in OBS Studio? It's Inception time. Okay, I'm sorry, but you guys have to suffer through the Inception screen. All right, so right there it says scene transitions. Okay, so there's nothing clearer than that. If you click on the list, you won't find anything. You have to add a new scene transition, and you have to choose stinger as the transition type, and then same thing as before. You click browse, you pick your transition. It doesn't ask you for the length. That's fine. Transition point, let's put 1,500 milliseconds, blah blah blah. Click okay, and now we don't even have a second scene. And now I just added a new scene. And now if I click on my second scene, boom, transition. Hopefully that works. If it doesn't, I'm gonna record it real quick. All right, let's say that you're not satisfied with the colors in the transition. First of all, like it's free, so I don't know what you're complaining about. But if you want to learn how to make your own transitions, click top right of your screen right now and figure it out. If you wanna have a preview of my other transition packs, click top right of your screen right now. And of course, check out the other rest of my videos on this channel. Recently, I made a video on how to make an animated webcam overlay in Microsoft Paint. I think it's impressive. Do you think it's impressive? Go watch the video. Anyways, gumroad.com/getlevel is where to go in order to find all of that. And thank you guys so much for watching. Get yourself some streamer brain merch, which is inverted. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching the video. Go out there, make me proud. A guy level out.